He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We thought that Lisa was done asking for favors, but she has it in her to ask for one more. I know, the nerve, but she did save your life that one time in Tijuana. So when she asks you to help fix the roof of her new house, you really have no choice. You grab your toolbox and climb on up there. But while you are getting situated, you drop your toolbox and it begins sliding down the roof. You shout to Lisa to catch the toolbox, but she was inside making Arnold Palmers, so it takes her a full 5 seconds to make it out there. The toolbox has a mass of 10 kilograms. The distance from the top of the roof to the edge is 10 meters. The roof is angled at 40 degrees off the horizontal and is 10 meters off the ground, and the coefficient of friction of the roof is 0.45. Given all this information, will she make it out in time to catch the toolbox? For this incredibly dramatic scenario, we need kinematics equations, Newton's laws, friction, and a little geometry and trigonometry, given the triangles and angles involved. If you aren't sure how to go about solving this, check out my tutorials on these subjects in the Classical Physics and Mathematics series. And when you're ready, give it a try. So what should we do first? Well, we always make a free body diagram first. The gravitational force acting on the box is 98 newtons, and that will point straight down. However, motion must occur at an angle, so let's break up this vector into two components that are parallel and perpendicular to the axis of motion. Then, let's trace a right triangle with the one component and this dashed line as the legs, and the original vector as the hypotenuse. This dashed line will be the same as the other leg of the triangle, and if we can find the missing sides of this triangle, we will have the magnitudes of the new vectors. To do this, we use trig functions. We have this angle here, 40 degrees. Given that the angles of a triangle add up to 180 degrees, and this other one is 90, this one must be 50. Cosine theta is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, so cosine 50 is equal to this component over the original vector. We can rearrange that to solve for this vector, and 98 cosine 50 equals 63 newtons. Then sine theta is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, so sine 50 is equal to the y component over the original vector. Again, we rearrange, and 98 sine 50 equals 75.1 newtons. Let's get rid of what we no longer need, and we are left with these two components of the gravitational force. We know there is also a normal force, which is perpendicular to the roof, and therefore equal in magnitude to this perpendicular component, but opposite in direction. Then with that, we are able to calculate the frictional force that opposes the sliding motion caused by this parallel component. That will just be the frictional coefficient times the normal force, which gives us 33.8 newtons in the negative direction. Now to get the net force, these two vectors cancel, so we combine these, giving us 63 minus 33.8. Or 29.2 newtons. And there's our net force. Now to find the acceleration of the box, that will just require Newton's second law, F equals ma. 29.2 goes in for F, 10 kilograms for m, and that gives us 2.92 meters per second squared as the acceleration. Lastly, given this acceleration, how long will it take for the box to reach the edge of the roof? We need an equation from kinematics that has distance, acceleration, and time. So let's use this one. 10 meters goes here, the initial velocity is zero, so this term goes away, and the acceleration is what we just calculated. We rearrange, take the square root, and we get 2.62 seconds for t. That'll get the box to the edge of the roof. Once it leaves the roof, it is falling another 10 meters straight down under the force of gravity. For that, we can approximate starting from rest in the vertical direction and plug in 10 meters, 0 for initial velocity, acceleration due to gravity, then rearrange, take the square root, and we get 1.43 seconds for the time it takes to fall from the roof to the ground. 2.62 plus 1.43 is 4.05 seconds, the total time for all of this chaos. Unfortunately, that means that when Lisa makes it out there 5 seconds after you shout for her, all she finds is the shattered remains of a trusty toolbox that once was. Sad, but hey, at least you don't have to do any more favors for Lisa. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.